Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. This is Newsbeat presented to you by Ladies Like. Follow the beat from the studio to the street. Info with the flow keeps you sharp and in the know. Sit back, relax, enjoy the news. Follow. Kampala City is quickly developing into an urban city and has been recognized internationally for its rapid growth and productivity. It has the core center of commerce, education and industry. However, the city has been affected by massive rural urban migration, stretching the city's infrastructure and creating congestion. The poor road network and insufficient road capacity has been the root of frequent traffic jam in the city. Japan has, however, concluded a loan agreement with Uganda to finance the construction of flyovers in Kampala. KCCA also has the use of cable cars and railway systems in plan to solve the traffic problems in the times to come. The capacity of drainage system, especially in the rainy season, has been insufficient, but the expansion of channels like Rubiji has brought some improvement. The city has also seen some improvement in solid waste management, with the World Bank funding the removal of Kampala's big landfill at Chitezi to boost the dumping site capacity for another 3 years. Kampala's over 2 million residents and growing middle class have also made a critical impact, as the city generates about 60% of Uganda's gross domestic products. And although the metropolis has expanded beyond the original seven hills that define the city, two-thirds of Kampala are yet to be built by the year 2050. Africa's youth are using education skills to create investment and employment. Our reporter MC Loy is here with the full report.
Youth-owned businesses have become the fuel of Africa's development. As the number of educated young Africans continues to swell on the continent, they have used their education and entrepreneurship skills to create investment and employment. George Ntamahanji is tackling Tanzania's rural energy shortages by building affordable small-scale power plants for business and domestic purposes. He builds the power plants from imported solar products from European countries. Under Sun Swiss Solar, his startup company, many girls in Uganda are denied any formal education, and this was the inspiration behind Best Ayowathis Girl Power Microcredit Organization, which has empowered hundreds of women with capital to pursue their dreams. She was recognized with Africa's Youth Entrepreneurship Award in 2013 after witnessing many mothers and newborns die under preventable circumstances. Cameroonians Alain Tef and Conran Toko founded Gifted to counter the unfortunate incidences. The SMS service offers advice on antenatal care, mothers, health and vaccination. Today the service has over 2,000 subscribers across the West African nation. Ugandan Titus Mawono managed to teach himself many computer code languages, which helped him to start up his own company, Fene, to assist small businesses. Fene offers inventory management, data storage and other accounting services. The company already handles over 400 small enterprises. Although most African youth lack financial support in terms of capital, the success of the few has proved to be pivotal. I'm MC Loy, reporting for Newsbeat.
Thank you, MC Loy, for that report. A lot is going on with our African leaders. Our reporter Blessed Sam is here with the details.
Africa has been gripped with the third time phenomenon, and nowhere has the fact been more evident than the Great Lakes region. Uganda was the first country to undergo the constitutional change in 2005, and the rest of the regional leaders followed suit to keep their presidential ambitions alive. A referendum was held in Rwanda to remove term limits, and 98% of voters voted yes in 27 of the 30 districts, granting President Paul Kagame a lifetime to run again in office. A constitutional amendment reducing presidential term limits was passed by Rwanda's Senate from 7 to 5 years, and also to maintain a two-term limit. President Kagame was also given a third-year term for the 2000 general elections, after which the new rules will apply per the constitution. The exercise received criticism from human rights groups and donor countries, and the only opposition group, the Democratic Green Party, which viewed it as a constitutional malpractice. Because the referendum was hurriedly conducted after 1 week's notice, over 92% of the voters in Congo Brazzaville also voted yes to remove the term limits in a controversial referendum that allowed President Denis Sassou Nguesso to run for a third term in office. The president had failed to secure his re-election because he was over the age of 70, which was not permissible under the constitution. Next might be President Joseph Kabila's turn. There are rumors that the DRC president might be considering to run for the third term. Although President Pierre Nkurunziza managed to start the constitutional change in his favor, Burundi now faces the possibility of plunging into yet another civil war. Experts say the removal of third-term limits might lead to incompetence and affect the democracy and the good governance on the continent. I'm Blessed Sun reporting for Newsbeat.
Thank you, Blessed Sun, for that report. From Cairo to Kampala, women are working together to make the city roads safer for each other. In Liberia, there are 40 female motorbike riders because the job has low pay and many risks for riders. DRS Coleman has been riding for 6 years. She was robbed, assaulted and worked in fear. And because of such assaults, these women banded together to make the Pink Panthers, a group of female riders who are mothers and breadwinners. In their 20s and 30s, providing their families and helping the country. 99% of the women in Egypt are sexually harassed, and men are doing nothing to decrease the assaults. So, Rimfosi founded Pink Taxi Cairo, a limousine service with only female drivers. It has surveillance ID scans and safety features for women and families to travel and feel secure. In Uganda, Mildred Abenyo quit her job and found Fit Click, a women's only gym and safe space to link fitness, well-being and self-defense. Since Ugandan leaders blame women's style of dress for rape cases and harassment, just like thinking being skinny equals to fitness. Like Apenyo said, for health development, you have to accept your body size at every moment. Thank you, Apenyo Fauzi and the Pink Panthers for questioning the norm and providing better answers. That was the news of the beat. Next week will be another hit, still ladies-like, reporting live and direct with love and respect. Follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat.
Follow the beat.
Follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat.
Follow the beat.